I looked at the program, and it's extensive, and we're so absolutely delighted. So if it's okay, I'll start a couple of minutes early. So, and anybody comes in late, we'll forgive them. But I do welcome all to the second installment of our Midday Noel for the 2018 season. I checked my facts and figures this morning and found out that we have been doing this now for 24 years. And so it's been our privilege to have you. Doing the math, that took us back to 1984. Is that right? 1994. That works. 1994. Was there anybody in the congregation right now who came to one of those first Midday Noels in 1994? Wow. Wonderful. Well, we're glad to have all the newcomers with us this morning as well. I do give thanks to Dr. Debbie Dalton for providing the arrangements for our Midday Noel series, and to the kitchen crew. On a cold, wet day like today, I walked into our Westminster Hall, and those baked potatoes just seemed to be the perfect thing to hit the spot today. So everybody is welcome to come to the baked potato lunch, once again, for a $7 donation. I'm going to give you a different route than we usually take in case it's raining again, but instead of you can go through these doors straight through all the way to Westminster Hall, but instead of going that way today, go through these doors, and when you exit the building, turn right, and you'll find our offices, and then turn left and go through our education building, and that way you can get all the way to Westminster Hall without a drop of rain hitting your head or your umbrella. So I do give thanks to Michael Murphy. Michael, please. I thought his last name was Murphy. We give thanks to Michael, please, Michael Murphy and the SFA National Seniors for being here today. Please note that kind of a time-saving thing is notice in your program, and I've already warned the choir, that it says, hold your applause. I know you're going to feel like applauding after every piece they play, but hold your applause, and we'll save it all for a loud crescendo of applause at the end of the program. Sorry. Scripture text from Matthew chapter 1, very familiar to us all. This is how the birth of Jesus came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man, he did not expose her to public disgrace. He had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife. Because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. The more I learn about Joseph, the more I reflect on Joseph, the more I appreciate him. But I do recall the time a young girl in Sunday school was asked to draw a picture, the Sunday school class, of the Nativity. And she took out her crayon and drew the stable and the star, and she drew the angels, she drew Mary, she drew the wise men, she drew the shepherds, she drew a cow and a sheep, an oxen, and even a goldfish. And when it was all over, when she had finished, she submitted it, and the teacher said, oh, Mary, where's Joseph? And she said, well, who needs Joseph? I heard one preacher describe Joseph kind of like the father of the bride. He's kind of there, and he has to pay for the whole affair, but nobody really notices him anymore. Well, Joseph was a carpenter. We all know that. He was a practical man. He probably was not a philosopher. He didn't deal in theory. He dealt in 11/32 of an inch and so forth, and precision. A man of great integrity. But one day, his dreams were shattered when Mary makes the announcements. He's thinking, I'm not going to build that home I dreamed of for us. He's embarrassed. He's angry. He's heartbroken. He's humiliated. And it doesn't say this in Matthew nor in Luke, but I'm sure it happened. Once Mary made the announcement to Joseph, and before Joseph had the dream, he went to the local pub. And there he asked, yeah, probably. And there he asked his friends, what should I do? And they said, it's easy. Just do what the Bible says. What does the Bible say? Just do that. That's easy. Well, expose her shame. Submit her to stoning. They didn't really stone people, but submit her to that. And Joseph said, well, I don't want to harm her. I don't want to abuse her. I don't want to expose her. And maybe he said that through the tears. And they asked, well, Joseph, where does it say that in the Bible? And Joseph said, it says that in the very character of God. And you know the rest of the story. Joseph and Mary go to Bethlehem. Joseph has the dream. They head to Bethlehem. And there in Bethlehem, the Son of God is about to be born. There's no room at the inn. There's only a stable. There's the loneliness. Mary has to be both midwife and mother at the same time. Joseph takes the crying child, puts him in a manger, and here comes these shepherds. Not dignitaries, but here comes the shepherds from the field with their stink, and nobody likes shepherds to begin with. And also, the filth, the animals. And I know, Joseph had to have questions. Many questions. But the amazing thing about Joseph, even in his questions, he always came down to do the right thing. And I think that's what you call faith. Will you please join me as we pray together the prayer found in our program? Who are we, Lord God, that you should come to us, yet you have visited your people and redeemed us in your Son? As we prepare to celebrate his birth, make our hearts leap for joy at the sound of your word, and move us by your Spirit to bless your wonderful works. We ask this through him whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
One more quick note. We are privileged to have today, I believe, the first grade class from Christ Episcopal Church, right here on the front pew. You can applaud for them. My last exam yesterday, so I'm feeling very festive. Mentioning about the clapping, but truthfully, it is really okay. If you feel that the Spirit moves and you would like to clap, it is fine by us. Okay. Now, we are just, I have to say, I'm just stunned. I just thought we would have a few of our closest friends with us. And you all, this is just a joy. So thank you for braving the elements today. You may look at our program and say, wow, they are doing the same composer a lot, Parker Shaw, and you think, well, he must have them on the payroll, but we don't. For the musicians out there who are choral musicians, there are very few of the holiday works that we just can trust all the time, and the arrangements that have been done by Alice Parker, who was way ahead of her time in the early early 20th century and 20s and 30s and 40s being a woman composer and her collaborator Robert Shaw. There's not one bit of ink that spilled is wasted. They're just so clever arrangements. So we're so excited to be able to give a lot of those carols in performing today. So that was Joy to the World, and we look forward to giving you the rest of the program. Hopefully it will warm your spirit in this cold rainy day.
Thank you. Let us be gay.
We go first to church and then we have the sweetest.
selection, I want to say a special thank you to Debbie for the gracious invitation, and all of you for attending. What a warm audience you have been. For all of those behind the scenes people who have made this happen, we are just so grateful to you. It's a great way to end our semester. It's always a Christmas miracle that students, not just because with everything they're in tremendous schedule, that they're still upright. But they're here. And it's been an extreme pleasure to be able to sing for you. I want us to actually come down into the chancel area in a horseshoe and sing our last piece, which is Go Tell It On the Horseshoe.
Thanksgiving for you, for Kelly.
of the benefits of having Stephen and Boston in our neighborhood. One of the sadness is that it seems like a lot of y'all are just temporary. You show up for about 4 or 5 years, but you always replace yourselves. And I give thanks that I know we have members of this choir that are members of our church choir, but also I understand several of you sing in other
choirs.
Other church
choirs
around town. So certainly benefits from that also. Thank you very much.
Wow.
Once again, lunch is served in Westminster Hall. Will you please bow for prayer? Almighty God, we give thanks for the gift of song. Thanks for these students for coming to share a festive season with us as we celebrate the birth of our Savior Christ. We pray now that you will bless the fellowship that we have as we continue to visit following the concert and use the food to nourish us and make us stronger and better servants of Christ our Lord. For it's in his name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.